Hi, it's Debbie Tudor. You like my hat? Huh? It's a mirror image, isn't it? If you met me at Summit, you might notice I've lost a good bit more weight. It really isn't that much difference on the scale, but I've truly leaned out, and this is why. Back in August, I started my fourth attempt to complete 90 days of P90X, and I always make it the full 90 days, but, you know, I haven't perfected it yet. But, well, I have a great support team, and that I've been with for, gosh, about 3 years now as I've tried this and lots of the other programs. Anyway, getting ready to do Les Mills Combat. I'm so excited. Why am I a Beachbody coach? Well, first of all, fitness is so important to me. My grandfather, my mother both had heart disease, so I've got it on both sides of the family. My ticker's pretty strong. In fact, I took beta blockers for just a few years, but a few months after taking Shakeology, my blood pressure was completely normalized. I've been off of all beta blockers for nearly 2 years now, so thank you, Shakeology. So fitness is very important to me, and I know that exercise is not just good for the body, it's good for my spirit, it's good for keeping my mood up. People, you know, ask me, why are you so happy? Why are you so, you know, energetic? But I can tell you that my mood and my energy and my level of joy is greatly influenced by whether or not I get that exercise in every day. Of course, I have a dog that gets me out walking, and that, you know, that's great. But fully developing the body so that I have a fully functioning vehicle to live my life in is, you know, it takes more than just walking, right? I am thankful for all of these Beachbody programs. The trainers are so incredibly motivating. I could go on about that, but I think I'll just say that my why is, for being a coach, is it keeps me uber accountable to my fitness. And I think I need that. I like the aspect of the accountability. In fact, I just can't imagine my life without it, really. I want to say something about owning my own business. I really enjoy owning business. I have a business with my husband, and I had my own business before I married him. And it was considered pretty successful by most people. I majored in business. I love studying things. I was the kid with the lemonade stand, so I like buying and selling and that sort of thing. The sort of thing that, you know, probably makes most people sick. And I like sharing and helping. I really believe that I am hardwired to be a nurturer. I love helping people. I love working with children, and I just know when people want my help, it's, you know, it's like a drug to me. And if I can give that, that gives me such a great sense of personal satisfaction, like I'm doing what I was meant to do. But I'm also very money motivated. I'm very insecure if I don't have a lot of money. I don't like being poor or broke. I have almost a phobia of that. So I have this fantasy where I do what I want to do, but then I have this reality where I sit down with the bank accounts and the checkbooks and I just anguish over being able to do all I want to do. I have big plans for the future. I still have a 12-year-old daughter, and, you know, I have big plans for her financially. So I'm not going to turn her into a trust fund baby, but, well, you know, I might. Anyway, one thing I like about owning my own business is there's something new all the time. It gives me a reason to keep up with things that, you know, are interesting to me, like what the tax laws are, or, you know, who's running the country and how that's going to affect business. And, so I feel like I have some skin in the game. I like that. I like being a businesswoman. I like being in a place where I have something that maybe can build an even greater future for me. Anyway, I've embarrassed myself enough. I love you guys. I'm going to hang up. You know, what are we doing, FaceTime? Thank you, David.